Good morning. My name is Steve Bloom. I'm the CEO of the Portland Japanese Garden, and it is my distinct honor and pleasure to welcome you all here today on this historic day for the Japanese Garden, for Portland, for Oregon, indeed for all of North America. Many speeches to come, but first I would like to bring to the stage and introduce our most wonderful board president, who became board president back in May and is doing a wonderful job leading an organization through a great deal of change, Mrs. Kathy Rudd.
Thank you, Steve. Good morning, everyone. Are you as excited as I am? Welcome to the Portland Japanese Garden on this historic day. Today, we are here to celebrate the beginning of a new chapter at the Japanese Garden. We will reflect on the past, remembering our humble beginnings and relationships we nurtured along the way. Maggie Drake and Bill DeWeese were instrumental, also with city officials, in securing the land, the trees, and shrubs that were given by proud Portlanders. Because of their vision, the Portland Garden began to take shape. We will welcome the future with open arms and hearts, for the best is yet to come in so many surprising and amazing ways. Yes, the Japanese Garden began over 52 years ago. Today, once again, we are extending our hearts and hands across the Pacific Ocean to our friends in Japan, who will help us embark on the Cultural Crossing Project. Before our very eyes, new gardens will take shape, a castle wall will hold up our mighty foundation of beauty, and an institute for the teaching of Ikebana, calligraphy, and tea ceremonies will become the heart and soul anchoring our Japanese heritage into our new village. A tea cafe will provide quiet reflection in conversation amongst visitors. When we think of the state of Oregon, we have a lot to be proud of. We have some of the best medical institutions, museums, and universities in the United States of America. However, when we think of the Portland Japanese Garden, we think world class, as our garden is known as the best garden in the world outside of Japan. Before I welcome two of our guests to the podium, I would be remiss if I didn't thank Steve Bloom, our CEO, one more time. It's his vision, and because of his vision, that our Cultural Crossing Project is in the works. I would also like to thank the Japanese Garden staff, because my gosh, they have spent hours and hours preparing to get us to this point today, and they have truly supported our dreams. And last but not least, the Board of Trustees, past and present, for their dedication and support. Without all of you, this project would not have been made possible. So now it's my pleasure to introduce to you Consul General Furusawa and Commissioner Nick Fish.
Truly a pleasure to be invited to join you all here today in celebrating this happy and momentous occasion. I think it is fair to call this celebration, as it is the culmination of many months and years of hard work. At the same time, of course, it is only just the beginning. Please allow me to express my appreciation to Kathy Rudd and Steve Bloom, as well as the esteemed Kuma Kengo. Also to Commissioner Nick Fish and Mr. Jordan Schnitzer for being with us here this morning. As I have said so many times before, I believe the Portland Japanese Garden to be a truly, truly precious cultural treasure, unique to Portland. The Cultural crossing expansion project that we are about to break ground on here today will usher in a new era of learning and communication between cultures, as well as interaction and relevance with the greater Portland and Northwest communities. Soon, through the International Institute for Japanese Garden Arts and Culture, the garden will provide a place where visitors can experience and learn about traditional Japanese arts in an immersive environment, offering even greater opportunities for education, cross-cultural interaction, and artistic expression to the people of this entire region, as well as the entire United States. What a priceless resource, as well as beautiful oasis the garden is poised to become. My sincere thanks again to Ms. Rudd, Steve Bloom, Sada Uchiyama, Diane Dawson, and all of the many more members of the staff and board. The hundreds of volunteers who have worked so hard to bring this amazing project to this point, as well as everyone here today. Thank you so much and congratulations.
Hi, my name is Nick Fish, Consul General, honored guests, members of the Board of Trustees, past and present, Director Bloom, staff, friends, family, and donors. What a wonderful day. I am here representing your City Council. As a past commissioner in charge of the Parks Bureau, I'm representing the Parks Bureau. But I think the reason Steve invited me is I just renewed my family membership. Gwyneth reminded me that this is a day 9 years in the making. Gwyneth, I would say it's 52 years in the making. And who knew you were so young? In 1961, when the zoo relocated to the other side of Washington Park, it left behind a degraded, unusable landscape. 2 years later, a group of visionary citizens approached the city and asked if they could transform that landscape into a world-class Japanese garden. It was the beginning of a long-term and rewarding relationship between the nonprofit Japanese Garden Society and Portland Parks and Recreation. And today we are so proud to celebrate and continue that strong partnership. Now more than 350,000 people from around the world visit the Japanese Garden. And I'm told they stay in our hotels and eat in our restaurants and help with the great vitality of our city. As has been noted, it is ranked as one of the best Japanese gardens in the world outside of Japan. Point of personal privilege at this wonderful day, this groundbreaking, let us declare it the best Japanese garden in the world. And today we get to come together to celebrate a new chapter in that remarkable history. On behalf of the city, I'd like to recognize important members of the Parks team who have been working collaboratively with the sponsor. And if you're here, would you please stand? Rachel Felice, Alan Schmidt, Kia Selly, Jeff Huff, and Mike Abate. Let's give the Parks and Rec team a round of applause. For their commitment to providing trail access that meets the community needs, and to property manager Trong Lam, who negotiated the lease agreement. Let's give Trong a round of applause. The garden is part of a vibrant community around Washington Park, and we would not be able to make this happen without strong neighborhood partners, and I would like to recognize them today. Southwest Park Neighbors, Inc., Sylvan Highlands Neighborhood Association, the Goose Hollow Neighborhood Association, Neighbors West Northwest, and Arlington Heights Neighborhood Association. We are a city of strong and dynamic neighborhood associations that contribute a ton of volunteer hours and and love and dedication to our community. Would you join me in recognizing all of our community partners? And finally, I want to just once again acknowledge our Consul General for honoring us with his participation today. And when I saw that he was wearing one of the most beautiful ties that I've ever seen, I said, in this country we have a tradition of exchanging ties at events like this. He said he would check with the protocol section and get back to me. You know, no matter the time of the year, I, like tens of thousands of Portlanders, come to the Japanese Garden to take in its quiet beauty and even sometimes to escape the insanity of public life. I can't wait to come back to this wonderful place when the project is complete. To all who have made this day possible, congratulations and thank you.
Thank you, gentlemen. I would like to also acknowledge a few other, we have so many important people in the audience, but there are a couple people I'd like to acknowledge at this point. Going back to the very beginning, Professor Tono, who designed this garden, in the genius of his design, wanted the proper implementation of that design. And he felt the way to do that was to make sure that we had leadership and guidance from Japan on an ongoing basis. And so he established the first ever director system here at the Portland Japanese Garden, in which a young gardener from Japan would come every about 3 years until their visa ran out and oversee and implement the building of this garden over the first 25 years of its history. And I believe we have three of those gentlemen with us today, including one who came all the way from Japan. And so I'd like to acknowledge Mr. Hoichi Kurisu. Mr. Takao Dunuma from Niigata, Japan. And Masa Mizuno, who was supposed to be here, but I haven't seen him yet. Masa, are you here? Okay. Well, there were eight of these garden directors over some 25 years that did so much to make sure this garden is what it is today. And so I think they deserve, as a group, a round of applause and our appreciation. I, too, would like to add my thanks to Portland Parks. They have been an amazing partner for us, with us for so many years. We have not done this size project in 50 years, and they have just been at the table from the very beginning, there with us every step of the way. And so I want to acknowledge Mike Abate, the Parks Director, as well. So thank you, Mike, and your entire staff. And of course, we have so much help, not here, just here in Portland and Oregon, but also on the other side of the Pacific in Japan. So many of our international advisory board members and supporters over there, one of whom has also come, my friend Aki Nakanishi, who is with the U.S. Embassy in Tokyo. And when we need the attention of the U.S. Embassy in Tokyo, he is our man behind the scenes making it happen. So Aki, where are you?
Where?
Oh, way in the back there. So. So many people have put so much into what we are about to build, and it's going to be hard for me to thank everyone individually, but certainly the design of this project is something that is and will be extraordinary. And one of the guiding principles when we started this project was that we would not do anything with this project unless it was of equal or greater quality of the existing garden. And in lining that up, we chose two of the finest designers in the world. Our very own garden curator, Mr. Sadafumi Uchiyama, as the landscape architect. Sada. And of course, the incomparable, amazing, talented genius of Kengo Kuma. Back in 2008, when I first walked into Kuma-san's office in Tokyo, my job was to just get his attention because I knew and hoped that he would be the man for the job. but I also knew how in demand he was around the world, and that he had not even done a project in North America yet. And so for us to bring him here to Japan, to Portland all those years ago, and to convince him to do this job, and for this to be his first public commission in North America is truly an honor. And so I'd like to ask Kengo Kuma to please come up and say a few words.
Thank you, everybody, for this great day. And finally, we can have this great groundbreaking ceremony. We have this day, there are many things already happened. And really love that gardens, because this garden is really beautiful and unique. You said, the best Japanese garden outside of Japan, but I think it's more than that. It's more unique than Japanese garden in Japan. As a combination of beautiful landscape of Portland and this garden is amazing. Because of you, great gardens will be more popular than before. After the completion of the building, probably the gardens will draw the attention from all over the world. Because of your support, we have this day, but the construction starts today. That means I should come more often to check every detail and every material. It's not hard for me. It's very happy for me because I can come to this beautiful garden. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Kuma-san. There are so many people who have had over the years such an impact on the garden. It's impossible to thank everyone. But there are some who have done so much more than others along the way. And today I want to bring our next speaker up, who is one of those gentlemen, who served on the board for 20 years at the Portland Japanese Garden, and at the time was the youngest board president ever to serve the garden at 36 years old. He was, I think, pulled in by his Aunt Mildred and by Bill DeWeese and brought into the garden family and has done so much. The garden house, which is no longer here, was Jordan's project when he was board president, and we're very sorry about that, Jordan. The establishment of the library, the hiring of the first professional executive director for the garden, the selection of, I believe it was the sixth or seventh garden director. There is just the establishment of the Bill DeWeese Hillside Garden. There are just so many things that I could name that Jordan accomplished during his time with the organization. Back in April, having the extraordinary opportunity to sit down with his mother and talk to her about an appropriate way to honor that commitment and all of that Jordan has done for this organization was really, truly a pleasure to see the light in her eyes as she wished to pay tribute to her son and a job well done. And Arlene can't be with us today here, but Jordan is here. And as I said, few have done as much for the garden as this man. And so please join me in welcoming Jordan Schnitzer.
In 1977, Bill DeWeese, who I had known a bit and admired so much, came knocking on the door and came to my office. And he asked me if I would consider joining the board of the Japanese Garden Society. I said, Bill, I just finished law school a year ago, and other than being at my Aunt Mildred's house as a kid running around and seeing all this Japanese stuff, I don't know anything about Japanese art and culture. And I said, the only thing I slightly have an interest in is when I was in law school in Lewis and Clark, and in the library when everybody else was studying and I was bored, I'd wander around, and suddenly I saw these magical flower arrangements every week. And I went and asked who did it, and there was a woman named Vesta Harrison, who you remember well, Maggie, and she was in the Sogetsu school that my Aunt Mildred had helped found. And that just became a wonderful experience for me to be able to contemplate and see this arrangement and so forth. So when Bill asked, I said yes, because I would have probably said yes to any civic group that came and asked me to start getting some experience. And it's because of Bill DeWeese that began this wonderful journey for me. As I was driving up today, I realized how we used to drive like a bat out of hell to get up here at 7 in the morning to have the garden committee meeting in the rain by the old meat house for the zoo. Always carried extra boots in the car so it wouldn't get too muddy. And he was fabulous. And you know, as Steve said and Nick Fish said, the garden was founded in 1962-63 by wonderful community leaders. And just being here today, I was able during my years to have known many of them, to have remembered Harold Hirsch, John Brook, Bob Franz, my Aunt Mildred, always, of course, Maggie, who's been the soul of the garden. I think this is more than just about the garden itself, which is incomparable, but it's also about civic leadership and the vision of a community and building upon tradition and legacy. If there's a lesson to be told from this, that is the lesson. Because sitting here today, to be sitting next to Douglas DeWeese and Alex, and next to Larry Vollum and Dory, I remember one of the first things I was asked to do is the tea house, which had been donated by Tektronix, had a little disrepair. And it was the first time I had to write a big cultural leader and ask for some money. So I wrote and then asked to meet with the Vollums, and Jean was usually the one to meet with, and she was wonderful. I didn't have to beg and grovel, as I often did with others. She was so generous, as your parents always were. And that led to really 20 years of really the joy of my life, of all the boards I've been on. Which of us has not come up here and seen the dew on a spider web in the morning and seen the wonderful job that Michael Kondo and the other staff has done, the way they maintain this garden? So of all the boards I've been on, this was the one that had the truest joy and delight to be here for those meetings. So today, I think we all follow in the steps of what Bill DeWeese taught me and others, and that was that the garden is an organic thing. It changes, it evolves. So even though we're here tearing down something that we did, that's the right thing to do, because this garden, like every civic organization, has to grow and evolve and serve a changing community. You either go or grow. So I applaud the leadership. I was blessed to serve a lot of years and follow in the footsteps of giants from the community. Others have come along. Gwyneth Gamble Booth did an incredible job during the 50th anniversary. I was chair during the 25th. Kathy Rudd, the board now, I think, is the strongest board ever in history. There's already been kudos to Steve Bloom, but when we first met and went to lunch and I laid out all the plans and visions I'd had years ago, by gosh, those are coming to fruition now through his brilliant, brilliant leadership. And to say that he is the best executive director of the Japanese garden in its history is an understatement. In my experience, he is without peer in terms of all the civic leaders in this community, and we're lucky because he could be anywhere in this country doing an amazing job at lots of places. So really a second thank you. So to finish, on behalf of my mother, who I am greatly honored that she is honoring me for the years of service I had here, and in essence with the bridge that I think I served of being able to reach back and touch those people who founded the garden and watch those who succeeded me who've continued to take this to new heights, I so appreciate being here today and being part of this. And as I said, the final message is there's an importance for those of us to follow those who came before us. There's a role for us to bring others and get them involved, for us to work hard continuing legacies of a community. And then there's a job of future leaders yet even unborn to step into our shoes and continue taking this garden, like other cultural institutions, to yet unknown heights. This is a huge step forward. Since the founding of the garden, as it was said, I can't think of anything that's as meaningful as what's going to be done here to promote the history, our love of art, culture of Japan, and gardens. So thank you again for honoring me. Congratulations. And we look forward to a few months from now being here again to celebrate the opening of this world-class facility. Thank you.
So as I mentioned, one of Jordan's premier accomplishments during his time as president was the building of the garden house, the maintenance facility. And I think he was a little shocked to come up here this morning and find it gone. Actually, we gathered around when the big machines came and started whacking it down. It was shocking to all of us. But we wanted to give you a little something as a memento and a reminder of that era and that time. And so from that garden house, we saved the head tile piece, which has our Japanese garden logo on it. And this is for you, Jordan. So it has a little plaque on it that has the birth and death dates of the building. And we would be remiss, and while Arlene could not be here today, she's here in spirit with us. I know that is a fact. Arlene was the first person I approached for a major gift to the campaign because I knew that having her stamp of approval and the Schnitzer family stamp of approval on this project would mean so much in moving forward in our credibility for this project. And so, in fact, she made the first $1 million gift to this campaign. And then for her a year and a half later, in April, to come back and not just give another million or 2 million, but to make the lead gift of another $5 million to this project is truly remarkable. So, Arlene, we love you, and come back to the garden and see us soon. So, as with all things, we are embarking on this, and we need to ensure on this construction site that we have a safe and prosperous site. And so, when we decided to move forward, I picked up the phone and I called my friend, the Chief Priest Yoshida of the Tsurugaoka Hachimangu Shrine in Kamakura, Japan, one of the most important shrines in Japan. And I said, would you be willing to send someone to do a blessing upon our site and upon this project? And he said, absolutely, we would be honored to do that. And he said, we'll send 6 people. How's that? I said, even better. Many of you may remember that Yoshida Guji came last year in July along with 24 performers from the shrine. And for the first time in the history of North America, performed the Imperial Dances of Mikagura here in Portland for the garden, and it was truly a remarkable and historic day. They've become wonderful partners of ours in the work that we do in spreading Japanese culture outside of Japan. I have a brief note here from Chief Priest Yoshida. It says, first of all, I'd like to present the warmest congratulations on the groundbreaking ceremony of the cultural village. It is my greatest pleasure that you invited us for the groundbreaking ceremony, as it manifested our partnership based on trust and respect of each other. I truly wanted to be here to serve the ritual, and really sorry for my absence. I wish you a lot of success in this on this great occasion. May bring greater success and prosperity to your new expansion for the cultural crossing at the Portland Japanese Garden. I look forward to seeing you in Japan. And so these gentlemen and ladies have come here to perform a blessing. During this blessing, there will be an offering of branches. And we have selected some of you to represent all of you. And so I just want to talk a little bit about that. And first in the offering of these branches will be myself and Kathy Rudd representing the staff and the board and the volunteers of the garden. Second will be Jordan Schnitzer and Travers Pollock, representing the many, many of you who have contributed to this campaign to make this project a reality. And then Maggie Drake and Doug DeWeese. Maggie Drake, who has been here with us at the garden from the very beginning, the first generation of the garden, and Doug DeWeese, the next generation of the garden, whose father was here, and now he stands proudly in his shoes. So they will be the third couple with a symbolic passing of the torch from generation to generation as we move forward. And then lastly, we will have the construction workers come up and also offer a blessing and be blessed. And then the grounds will be blessed, and there'll be a bit of explanation. So please join me in welcoming our very dear friends from Tsurugaoka Hachimangu in Kamakura.
First, priest purifies altar and attendants. Please bow. Thank you. Please bow again. Thank you. The next is priest is calling divine spirits to the tree at the altar and offers food. Please bow. Thank you. The next is a priest chant a prayer for safety of the workers and great success of this project. While chanting, please bow.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next is a priest purified the construction area and a space. The next is Shrine Maiden's Dance. The Shrine Maiden dedicate a dance to pray for the eternal peace and prosperity. The next is a tamagushi offering. Please offer the evergreen tree branch on the altar. Then, bow twice, clap twice, and bow once to pay respect. Thank you. As closing, the priest closed the lid of the sake bottle and requesting the divine spirit to return to the nature. Please bow. Thank you.
Thank you very much. In this ceremony, I offered a sincere prayer for the success on this project and prosperity for Portland Japanese Garden. Also, I would like to say thank you very much, Mr. Bloom, and all staff of Portland Japanese Garden for giving us this opportunity. Thank you very much.
Hello? Ah, there we go. Thank you very much. One more time, let's show our appreciation to our friends from Kamakura. In just a moment, we're going to move over and put on some hard hats and grab some shovels. There are so many people to thank, and I want to just take a moment right now. First and foremost, I and we at the Garden would not be anything and would not be able to accomplish anything without what is the most amazing staff that work here day in and out that make this place go. And no matter where I am, I know that this place is humming because of the work that they do each and every day. Every single gardener, every single ticket taker, my senior staff from top to bottom, I could not be more proud of them. And I think Portland could not be any luckier than we are to have this amazing group of people who care so much and so passionately about this garden. So please join me in appreciation to the Portland Japanese Garden staff. I want to thank this amazing design team led by Kengo Kuma, by Thomas Hacker and Associates, Walker Macy, Sadafumi Uchiyama, so many people. Jonah Cohen, who is our project manager, who has led this thing so ably as we've moved along through many hills and valleys. It's just been remarkable to watch them work. To Hoffman Construction, who has done an incredible job, and up until now we haven't had to pay them a dime. Everything they've done for the last year and a half has been pro bono. So, to all of you, thank you very much. To the City of Portland, the State of Oregon, to Portland Parks, thank you for your cooperation and helping us to make this project a reality. As co-chair of this campaign, you have done a remarkable job. Both here and in Japan, and being an ambassador. And so please join me in thanking our amazing Capital Campaign Chairs. And I just know I'm forgetting someone, so please forgive me if I have, but you are the Japanese Garden family here that has made this happen. And today, we are making history. And we're gonna all meet back here in April of 2017 under the cherry blossoms of this cherry tree right here. As we have a ribbon cutting ceremony for the grand opening. And we hope our friends from Kamakura will return at that time as well. So with that being said, I'd like to invite the following people to don a hat and a shovel.
Steve, if I strike gold, we'll finish the campaign.
Right.
It's
just spray paint. Move all the way over. Keep going, Kathy. Keep going.
That's right.
right there. Just right there.
Not that long. Catch.
Ready? And so on this day, let's go.
Two more years.